saying, he said, Karsh, Brother Karsh, public speaking is like the desert, is like the sand of the desert. It blows constantly without doing any good. There's some good in it, some
talk,
reason.
Talk, though, about that capturing someone's soul in a picture, because you do, whether it's Harry Truman, who in a sense looks like Puck, the mischievousness of this man is there, or Ronald Reagan. What do you do that captures that soul, Mr. Karsh?
Well, I suppose I'm imbued with their contribution to the world. That is easy enough.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't have any intelligent answer to that very interesting question. But I go there with a great deal of preparation. My experience come to my help. And there is some little gift which I have that we have immediate rapport, immediate understanding. And then you leave everything unfold naturally. With President Reagan, it's not unusual to feel that he treats portrait photographers very much like he would treat a director of the film. He would accept it. With President Truman, he looked so congenial because it was soon after the headline in one of these papers said, Dewey had won. All these are circumstances that come to your assistance.
The pictures of Fidel Castro.
Yes.
You seem to have a different view of him than we are seeing at the moment.
At the moment, of course, is very unfortunate and very sad. But these photographs must not speak only the moment, but rather
to the generations.
Must be to generations to come. I treated him principally as a man of letter, and he reads. Yeah. As you mentioned, the reading of Camus earlier, Sartre and Hemingway, etc. And as such, he is a fascinating man as a human being. But as a politician, that's something else.
Mm-hmm. You spent time in Russia?
Yes, on the invitation of Khrushchev, my wife and I, and we spent 7 weeks photographing their dancers, their men of letter, I photographed Konstantin Simonov, who is their foremost writer. He was the Hemingway of Russia, if you please. And when he received my wife, he raised a glass of wine. He said, I drink to your shoes, the shoes that brought you under my roof.
How lovely. As I'm holding this up, and we're going to break for 1 minute, but we're going to come back and talk about the segment in this book called On Assignment, which is, in a sense, a departure from your usual work.
Complete.
We will be back. Welcome back. We're talking with Yusuf Karsh, author of Karsh, 50 Years of Retrospective, published by Little Brown. Mr. Karsh, I'm holding up for the camera and our friends to see the segment that is On Assignment. Now, this is not a head of state. This is not an actress. These are people.
But my interest is equal with plain, ordinary men and women as well. This is especially significant to me because you see a great deal of nobility, even though the man is unknown. He was a patient coming to a hospital with all his worldly belonging in this white bag and his white cane to have an operation for cataract. But happily, I followed through. He was cured and flown in a helicopter to his homeland. The same thing with the lady in the hospital, the Eskimo lady. And you feel a great deal of serenity. It gives you comfort to know that her belief that she will soon be cured because of the affection and understanding she will have from doctors.
Mr. Karsh, I am most aware in this book of, as I said, you're looking for the nobility in humankind. But I don't see any too much, what have you ever taken off the Turks? What goes back to your childhood in Armenia? And the Holocaust of the Armenians. Have you ever been able to photograph something that speaks to that?
Well, I wish there could be. That applies to all the inhumanity to man today. I wish you could find the answer, what we could photograph to deter this sad infliction of oppression and massacres. But I do believe I came out very rich from that experience, although a heavy price to pay. I lost three of my family uncles that were very gifted in the massacre between 1914 and 1918. But I had a remarkable mother who, where on one occasion I went to her at the age of 7 I was. The Turkish children wanted to search my pocket. What could there be in them? Just a few marbles. Yeah. So I resented and did not give it to them. So they took a stone and hit me right in the forehead. I went to my mother bleeding but defiant. I said, wait, from now on I will be the one who will carry small stones with me. And then she took me closer to her. She said, my son, do you really think they know what they are doing? However, if you have to retaliate in self-defense, be sure you miss. Do not come to their level. And that wonderful advice of let the bygone be bygone, if you can set an example that you are an Armenian by descent, a very proud Armenian, you are a Canadian, you are a citizen of the world. By your example, you can create more goodness than you would defiant and challenging.
I think that is what I feel in what you have here in this book. And that's what I began the show by saying, the nobility in humankind, the sense of reaching for something greater and better outside of ourselves. Let me just hold up the back because there is, who took this picture?
I took that myself. I set up the camera, had a Polaroid made of one of the boys in my studio, and sat down and gave myself the benefit of the doubt.
And what did you say to yourself, Mr. Karsh? I mean, having investigated your own history.
That you have to be, set a good example to amateur photographers, that self-photographs, self-portraits could be made rather interesting.
Mr. Karsh, will you autograph my book for me? It is something I shall treasure.
Thank you.
I wish I could hold up each and every page for you all to see, because each page is like having a photographic art gallery in your home with this book. It is a book, again, as I've said, get one of those cookbook stands, put this book up, and each week turn a page so your family can share that experience. If you're interested in writing, each page is almost, give you a jumping off spot to write a short story. Because each person has a story, and in their eyes is the world. If you would like a copy of our publication, Good Books, write to me, Connie Martinson, P.O. Box 691640, Los Angeles, California, 90069. We'll tell you about some other books we've liked recently. Merrily Zdenek's The Right Brain Connection, important book, again, if you're creative, because she has all the exercises here to make you almost leap into your own subconscious and find intuitively where is the creative aspect and how can you use it. Another very important book, The Little Black Pill Book, put out by Bantam. This is a book that will tell you about prescription drugs that are overused and ill-used, and what are some of the side effects. It may not be your fault that you're feeling nervous, drugged, paranoia. It may be some of the medication you're taking, and be sure to question your doctor, but you also have to be responsible for yourself. The Organized Executive, important book again if you're working, teaches you how to put your things in order, what sort of a file cabinet even to order. Very good book for someone just going back to work. And I must tell you before we leave, a book that is also a beauty, The Joy of Pasta. Marvelous pictures, great sort of, terrific recipes on various eating of pastas. And don't forget the book my friend Mr. Karsh has photographed and written, Karsh, a 50-year retrospective published by Little Brown. You will be glad that you've enriched your own life. Thank you, Mr. Karsh,
so much. Great pleasure to be with you indeed.
We will see you next week.